In C++, the primitive string type is an array of characters terminated with a null value. This is sometimes referred to as a C string or a null terminated string to distinguish it from the object-oriented string types. I have a string here, and it's declared as an array of characters. The character type is technically an integer of a size suitable for holding a character, which is 8 bits on most common systems. So a string is an array of characters terminated with a zero value. So this 6-character string takes up 7 values in the array. So this is an array of characters. I can display it with puts. I can iterate through it with a for loop and print each character individually. And so when I build and run this, you see I display the string, and then I display each character, 0 through 5, 6 characters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm not displaying the null terminator. So this is what a string is. It's an array. But this line of code, what this does is, of course, it declares the array, and it copies the literal string into the array. The literal string was not originally in the array. It was separate as a literal string. And in order to put it into the array, it needs to be copied. Now, most often, you don't actually need to do it that way. You don't need a copy of the string. So what you'll see more often is this. A character pointer, which is assigned to the address of the literal string. And you notice it needs to be const qualified because the literal string is naturally immutable. In fact, in modern versions of C++, it wasn't always this way, but in modern versions of C++, if I don't have this const qualifier and I try to build, I get a warning that C++ 11 does not allow conversion from string literal to character pointer. And if I click on this, well, it doesn't offer to fix it for me. But the way to fix that is to make this a const character pointer. And so putting const in front of character pointer like this actually makes the pointer a pointer to const char. It doesn't make the pointer itself a constant. It makes what it points to, the type of the pointer, as const char. So it's a pointer to constant characters. If you actually wanted to have a constant pointer that cannot be changed, you put the const after the asterisk. And of course, that still works, and you just can't reassign the pointer to something else. I can't come in afterwards and say cstring equals like null pointer or something. If I try to build that, it says I can't because it's a const pointer, but I can if I do this. Of course, it wouldn't work very well and it would crash. So what we have here with the const character pointer, this works exactly the same as it did with the array. We can still index it as if it's an array. We can treat it in every way the same way. The only difference is we're no longer copying the literal string into an array. So we're saving some time, we're saving some code, and it's more efficient this way, and this is the way that you'll normally see it. One other thing I want to show you is string concatenation in C++. If I wanted to add another string on the end of this, I could say another string. You notice I have a space in there before it. Concatenating two strings in C++, at least two literal strings, is just a matter of putting them one after the other. More often than not, you'll see this when they're on separate lines, something like this. And so when I build and run, you notice that we now have 20 characters and it says string another string. So C strings are a very simple form of strings, much simpler than the string class provided by the STL. For circumstances where you don't need the power of object-oriented strings, C strings are simple, small, and fast, and they're very common in C++. Some characters in C++ have special meaning or are otherwise not normally accessible within the parameters of the C++ language. Escape sequences are used to access these characters. Each escape character begins with a backslash character. And if you need to type the actual backslash character, then you use a double backslash to result in a single backslash. So I'll go ahead and build and run this, and you can see that it displays hello world. And if I want to add a single quote, I use backslash single quote. I use backslash double quote to get a double quote. I use two backslashes to get a backslash. Or backslash x40, I can access any character in the ASCII table by giving its hexadecimal value beginning with an X. And so this will be the at sign. And if I go ahead and build and run here, you see I get that single quote, double quote, backslash, and the at sign. If I want to get a new line, I can use backslash N. And if I want to get a tab, I can use backslash T. And if I go ahead and build and run this, you see we have a new line and a tab. So world is starting indented there on a line by itself. You can get any character in the Unicode table on a system that supports Unicode. I can say U03BC. And this will give me a Greek letter mu on systems that support this. So when I build and run, you'll see the Greek letter mu there. Notably, Microsoft Visual C++ does not support Unicode by default, at least as of the time that I'm recording this. So your results here may vary. So this is a table of the most common standard character escape sequences. You can find a table like this online pretty much anywhere. Character escape sequences are commonly used to provide special characters and string constants that may not otherwise be accessible on the keyboard or due to conflicts in the language. The standard C++ library provides a number of functions for working with C strings and are found in the C string header. This is where the string functions are declared. We've also got some constants, a max buff size, 128, a couple of string constants, string 1 and string 2, and then we have a couple of character buffers, SD1 and SD2, inside of main, along with an integer, a character, and a character pointer, which we will use for various purposes in our demonstrations. First up is str n copy, and you'll notice that this has an n in the middle of the name. Many of these functions have this n in the middle of their names. This means that the function uses a count argument to limit the number of characters upon which it will operate. There are often other versions of the same functions that do not have the n in their names. Try to favor the version with the n, as it is usually more stable and safe. So str n copy is used to copy a string from one place to another, and here we're copying the constant string S1 into the buffer SD1, and we're using maxbuf as the count. It will copy up to maxbuf minus 1 characters, and we do the same with SD2, and if I build and run, we can follow along here, and you see at the top of our results here is our printfs, SD1 is and SD2 is string 1 and string 2. Next is str n cat for concatenating strings. First, we concatenate a space dash space string into SD1, and then we concatenate SD2 on top of that. And each time we're using as our count the length of the max buff minus the length of the string minus 1. And so we do this in both cases. And that's the length of the destination string, so that we know that there's enough room in there for the concatenation. And you notice our result here, SD1 is now string 1 dash string 2 with the spaces around the dash. String length, str n length, will get the length of a string. And again, it uses the count max buff so that it doesn't count past the end of a buffer. Str n len returns a size t value, and so you'll notice in our printf we're using the zd for the value. Str cmp for comparing strings. This returns a 1 if the comparison is greater than, a minus 1 if it's less than, and a 0 if the strings are identical. And so here we compare them, and you notice that we get a result of not equals for SD1 and SD2, and the value is minus 5, and we have a 0 for comparing SD2 to S2 because they are identical. Str chr is for finding a character in a string. And here we set our character variable to the letter N, and we search for the N in SD1. And did we find an N? Yes. And str char returns the position of the first matching character, or null. And there's also a version that searches from the right, which is str rchr with two R's in the middle there. And there's str str, which searches for a string in a string. And you notice down here we're looking for S2 in SD1. And of course, yes, we find it, and we find it at position 13. And again, str str returns the position of the string or null if it's not found. Many systems have non-standard extensions to this function, so be sure to consult your system documentation. Even if you're using C++, you should never be afraid to use C strings. There are times when they're necessary, and there's times when they're just smaller and faster than C++ STL strings. These functions are a great resource for working with C strings.